My dear brothers and sisters, I have the pleasure to introduce to us the wonderful minister of God that God has for us tonight. I have the pleasure to introduce Reverend Father Anthony Mado. God bless you, Father, as you take over from me.
My dear sisters and my brothers, I welcome you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Tonight, I would like us to reflect on Jesus is interested in me. Sometimes we think that God has abandoned us. But I'm telling you tonight that Jesus is interested in you. Jesus is interested in me. That's the caption of tonight's reflection. I would like us to reflect on Gospel of Luke chapter 19 from verse 1 to 10. That's where you will be able to see that really God is interested in each and every one of us. In spite of what people say about you, in spite of what people say about you, in spite of who you are, in spite of your unworthiness, God is interested in you. Tonight is your night, my dear brothers and sisters. Tonight is your night. Let's go into prayer. Loving Father, I thank you for the wonder of our being. I thank you for the wonder of our being. I thank you for the grace of being with us. In spite of our unworthiness, Lord, you're able to say that tonight is our own night. We have appointment with you tonight. And you have showed us your love. And you have showed us your mercy. You have showed us your kindness. You are able to tell us that we can be a friend of God. And at the same time, be a child of God. And so, Father, since you have invited us to be with you tonight, I commend my whole brothers and sisters in this life into your care, into your divine care, that they will receive your divine benevolence, that they will receive your divine favor, that they will receive your divine kindness and mercy, that no weapon shall be fashioned against them. I know that we have a living God. Our God is an awesome God. We have a good shepherd that is always taking care of his flock. And so, Father, I crave your divine indulgence to shower your divine grace upon your people, that the blessing of tonight will penetrate into the bone marrow of my brothers and sisters, will go through their life and heal and annihilate any type of uncleanness and unworthiness in them, and to be able to have you as an indwelling of them in the Holy Spirit, so that you shall plant your tent in our house and be able to bless each and every one of us, our siblings, our friends and relations, in-laws, in name of God the Father, and God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, our cosmic glance at Book of Psalms 17, verse 8, will tell us that our God, we are the apple of God's eyes. The psalmist says in Psalm 17, verse 8, keep me, Lord, as the apple of your eyes. I'm telling you tonight that Jesus is interested in you. If Jesus is interested in you, who cares what the gossipers are saying? Who cares what the atheists are saying? Who cares what the world is thinking about you and your family? Who cares? You have to focus on the Lord. No distraction. You have to focus on the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters. You have to focus on the Lord. It is only in the Lord that there is joy. It is only in the Lord that there is happiness. It is only in the Lord that there is peace. It is only in the Lord that there is genuine friendship and solidarity, honesty and truth. Jesus said, I am the way. I am the truth and life. Jesus is telling you today, I am interested in your business. Tell your brother, tell your sister, Jesus is interested in me. Jesus is dying for my love. Jesus is interested in me. He don't care what the world sees about you. Look upon the cross and see that someone is dying for you. Someone died for you. Someone paid the right price for you. So why are you depressed? Why are you oppressed? Why are you feeling dejected and abandoned? Why are you feeling lonely in that heart? Why are you feeling lonely in that heart? I'm talking to you. Stop crying. Yes, you. You think that you're only alone. Nobody cares about me. You are groaning for mortal men and women that will die like us. Who is that person that's pulling you down? What is that thing that puts you down? Let me tell you tonight. You have to crush it, both in spirit and in truth. Because if you look at Psalm 118, you will see that they compass you. They compass you. But in the Lord's name, you crush them. When enemies compass you, they lay like tongues among fire. But in the Lord's name, you crush them. Look at Psalm 118 and find favor and solace. Look upon the Lord. Jesus is interested in you. And the Psalmist chapter 17, verse 8 says, keep me, Lord, as the apple of your eyes. You are the Lord's apple. The Lord's eyes is on you. For good, not for bad. Not looking at the hurry eyes that hurt you. Look at Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. Look at the six things that Lord abhors and hates. The first thing was the hurry eyes and the lying tongues and signs. Is that what you are looking for? People to glorify you? People to sing your praises? You are missing the point. You are missing the point. They will praise you. They will sing Hosanna for you. Oh, at your back, crucify him or her. Look at, you are the apple of God's eye. Say to yourself, look at yourself in the mirror and say, I am God's apple. I'm the apple of God's eye. Read chapter 2, verse 8. He will say, thus says the Lord of hosts, after glory, he has sent me against the nation which plunders you. For he who touches you touches the apple of his eyes. Look at that. God is fighting your battle, my dear brothers and sisters. God is fighting your battle. Anybody that touches you touches the apple of God's eyes. Zechariah chapter 2, verse 8. You don't even know that you are very costly and you are crying like a poor man. Nobody is poor in the eyes of the Lord, because God has already bought you over with the precious blood of his only son. Hey, I'm talking to you. Look up. Stop bending down. What is weighing you down? Look at you. You're wearing off. You're supposed to be happy. What is that is weighing you down? Let me tell you, whatever that is making you to have sleepless nights, God knows about everything you are thinking of. Do you think that God does not know you? Do you think that you can pass every day unnoticed in the eyes of the Lord? Okay, let me help you understand the world. Do you know how many times your heels, your shoe has crushed each insects, the soldier ants and so on? You don't even see them. You march on them and you move. And God always give them medication. God gives them first aid, and you match your hand. In America, they have animal hospitals. How many animal hospitals are inside the thick forest of Africa? You have your gardens around all over, and you sprinkle water over your grasses. How many are sprinkled in the forest? I'm talking to you. Compare and contrast what God takes care of and what human beings take care of. You labor and toil to do that. And if you don't cut your grasses, oh yeah, your county will talk about it now. You pay for it. But in the forest, you see how they are, both in dry season and in the wet season. God is taking care of all of us. Tell your sister, tell your brother, God is taking care of you. Look at the book of Psalm 34, verse 15. It says, the eyes of the Lord is on the righteous. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous. And in 1 Peter chapter 3, from verse 12 to 16, says, the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous. And let us look at Gospel of Luke chapter 19, from verse 1 to 10. That's where we shall dwell tonight. It started by saying that Jesus was passing through Jericho. Of course, Jesus has to pass through somewhere. Jesus is passing through your house tonight. We're talking about Jericho. Let your house be that Jericho. Jericho is too far. You have never visited Jericho. Your house is the Jericho where Jesus will come. Your own county is the Jericho where Jesus will pass. Your own state is where Jesus is trying to walk tonight. Wherever you are, think about Jesus passing along the street and is trying to locate your own house. Imagine it now. And then there was a man in verse 2 named Zacchaeus. Gospel of Luke chapter 19 from verse 1 to 10, if you open your Bible. Zacchaeus was a tax collector, very wealthy man, stinking rich. And he heard about Jesus, and he wanted to see who Jesus was. He just wanted to see who Jesus was, out of curiosity, not out of belief, not out of faith, but out of curiosity. He was very curious. He wanted to know who Jesus was, out of curiosity. What brought Zacchaeus out from his house, from his wealthy house, was that he has heard about this Jesus. He was very rich. He was not coming to Jesus to give him money. He was thinking rich. He was not coming out to beg for money or to ask Jesus to make him to be rich. No, 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 no. He was okay. He was okay, my dear brothers and sisters. But what was troubling him was curiosity. He wanted to see who Jesus was. That was how the Bible presented it. And curiosity brought him closer. You have to ask yourself tonight, what brings you closer to Jesus? What makes you look for Jesus? Is it for miracle? Is that why you pursue people that perform miracles? What brings you to Jesus? Can you see beyond what you are looking for? I'm talking to you. Yes, you. What brings you closer to Jesus? Is it your problem? What if Jesus solves your problem? Will you leave Jesus? I'm talking to you. Think about when you didn't have that problem. How many times do you pray? How many times do you pray? Ask yourself, why are you looking for Jesus? Is it because of your present predicament? Why are you looking for Jesus? Or are you with Jesus because you have faith? This is examination of conscience. What brings you to Jesus? Is it truth? Is it love? Stop thinking about somebody. Think about yourself. Think about your own family. What is bringing you closer to Jesus tonight and always? For Zacchaeus, it was curiosity. Let me tell you. Barrenness may bring you closer to Jesus. Sometimes God's ways are not our own way. God knows each and every one of us one by one. Brokenness can bring you to Jesus. Sickness can bring you to Jesus. Love for Jesus can bring you closer. What you went through in life may have brought you closer to Jesus. You figure your own one out. Figure out what brought you to Jesus. And if you were able to get something from Jesus beyond the material stuff, then you are worshiping God in spirit and in, as said in Gospel of John chapter 4 from verse 22 to 24. Because time has come when true worshippers shall worship me in spirit and in truth. You know, remember, Zacchaeus was a short man, you know. Natural barriers may make you not to move. You may be shy because of what you are or who you are. I was discussing with somebody in a therapy, I won't call the name. She said that she didn't want to come out because she was too big, too fat. And that her friends, they're all lanky and so on, and she doesn't want to come out, she doesn't want to go to the beach. I say, let me tell you, let me ask you one thing. Were you the one that created yourself? You say, no. Did you make yourself to be like this? No. I said, bring me your picture when you were small. And this girl was big from the mother's womb. Even the mom went through CS before she came out. She was too big. And so I said, this was a natural endowment, if I may use that word, if I may use that phrase. You see, sometimes what is going on with you may not have been caused by you. I know that some people eat or drink and something happens. You can change certain things. You can swim against current. You can walk against nature. Because we have been told in Genesis to conquer the earth. America has conquered the earth. We used to go through the boat. They brought engine boat. We used to walk. They brought the car. Many people are now in a civilized country. We used to go through the engine boat. But then there was train. Then there was a helicopter, there was plane, and so on. And we're enjoying, we are conquering the earth. When there is snow, we put on the heater. You have to figure out how to conquer your own natural barriers. You have to be motivated by yourself. You don't need any external things, because when they are not there, you are alone. It has to come from within. I'm talking to you. Yes, you. You and your child. You have to sit up. Don't allow anything to weigh you down. You have to move. Jesus said, go and make disciples of. He didn't say stay. He said go. You have to do something. Even when the crowd was moving, and the crowd were waiting upon the Lord, and it was already night. Jesus told the apostles, give them something to eat. You have to do something. You don't wait every time. You have to do something. I'm talking to you. Don't stay on the couch and say, oh, this is weighing upon me. This is too much. No, no, no. Once you have life, there is hope. Once there is life, there is hope. Don't give up upon yourself. Don't be defeated by yourself. You have to tell yourself, I'm in charge. Do not condemn yourself because God loves you, no matter your condition. Do not allow anything, do not allow your environment to entrap you or define you. You have to be in charge of your environment in a good way. You have to be in charge of yourself. You are so precious to allow anything to weigh you down. What the hell is that? Zacchaeus had his own natural barrier. That's where I'm coming from tonight, man. Zacchaeus had his own natural barrier. He was able to break that natural barrier. He didn't allow his natural condition to stop him from his quest and his adventure to see Jesus. He broke the yoke in his life. He was compelled by curiosity. Remember, the crowd worsened the situation, and he could not see over the crowd. Are you with me tonight? The crowd worsened the situation for Zacchaeus that was very small. He was very pinchamic. And he did not even care about the crowd. In Gospel of Luke chapter 19 verse 4. So he ran ahead. He ran ahead, my dear brothers and sisters. Zacchaeus ran ahead of the crowd. He ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree. He was able to use the natural endowment around him. He was able to use the environment to achieve what he wanted to do. That's what I'm talking to you tonight. You have to use what is around you in a good way to achieve your aim. I'm talking to you. You don't need anybody to motivate you. You have to move. If you want to achieve something in your family, if you want to achieve something in your life, you have to move. The people that want to get gold medal, they wake up early in the morning and they run. When they come back from after sleeping and eating, they run even in the night. They want to be physically fit. They want to be breathing very well. They don't want to be gasping and panting when they're climbing upstairs. You have to help yourself. I'm talking to you. Yes, you. I'm talking to you. Yes, I'm talking to your family. Yes. You are hearing the word of God tonight. It is full of life. It's a prophecy and a mystery. You have to wake up. God is talking to you and your family tonight. And God is talking to me, Anthony. Look at the Bible and find solace. Don't look at the world to get your own solace and motivation. The world will disappoint you. The world will tell you, what are you doing? Forget about it. But you have to move. When you look at the Bible, see how Zacchaeus was trying to see the divine. See how he was trying to see God. He was able to break his own barrier. He didn't even mind the crowd. The crowd was not helping him. He has to look around. Ask, can you shall receive? See, can you shall find? Oh, he was searching for Jesus. Are you searching for Jesus now? Are you trying to help yourself? In many ways, look at how Zacchaeus was able to break his own barrier. He was able to break the yoke. He didn't even know what was pushing him. It was Jesus. If Jesus comes into your life and around you, you never remain the same. You never remain the same. You never remain the same because Jesus is around. Oh, mighty Jesus. Just that Jesus was passing. Jesus was passing and Zacchaeus was uncomfortable. Oh, he was able to move around and was able to move around. He was able to break his barrier because because Jesus was passing. Hey, Jesus is moving around your street. Jesus is moving around your county. Oh, something is happening tonight in your house. I'm talking to you. Oh, you can claim that blessing, that breakthrough, that barrier is already around. I'm talking to you. You claim your own barrier. You claim your own blessing. You claim your own divine breakthrough. I'm talking to you. Look at what Zacchaeus did today. You can do it in your own health. You can also do it in your own brother and sister, your siblings. You can also help them out. I'm talking to you tonight. I'm talking to your family. You can help yourself. Yes, you can help yourself. You can. I told you last time about the cripple that came to my office. It was because during the time the parents were alive, they brought him to the hospital. They brought him to the hospital to be immunized. And during the war, the nurses that we are giving him that vaccination and all the immunization stuff, they paralyzed the young man. The two legs were paralyzed. Somebody that was born full of life came to the hospital to receive vaccination and immunization. And son was paralyzed, and the only son became crippled, and the clan and the people around him wanted to take his own land. I told you the story. If you want to listen and see what happened, you can order for the DVD. It's called Leave My Land Alone. Hapolomanam. God fought for you. He came to my office and said, Father, my people want to take my only inheritance. And I prayed and blessed him. I blessed his crucifix. I blessed his chaplet. I blessed his Bible. I said, go, they will not take your land. And as God may have it, one of the recalcitrants, you know, in every umunna, in every clan and kindred, you may have someone that is very stubborn. So one of the kindreds and the classmen, they just brought him out and said, if you don't go away from here, we shall just kick you out. And they really kicked him out. They picked him up like a little clothing and sent him away from where they were about to sell land. And lo and behold, lightning and thunder smashed that man, Pierre. God is alive. If you want to watch the video, you can see it. God really walked. Smashed the land, the man. The man that picked that crippled man wanted to take him away from the land. Lightning and thunder came down from heaven and smashed him. And he fell down. And the rest of the homeowner, the clansmen, and all, they ran away, including the rich man that wanted to buy the land. God we serve, watches from afar. Look up Book of Psalm 2. Psalm 2. God is laughing at the enemies and the wicked from afar. It's only when God allows certain things to happen, things happen. Then this man woke up and it's very interesting. This crippled man said, God, please. They will say that I went to get a charm to kill my clansmen and so on. And he placed the crucifix and blessed upon that man. And the man woke up and he sneezed and looked around. Nobody was around with him except that crippled man he wanted to pick up, remove from the land. He was on the land with him, and he tested the land and the sand. You know, sometimes when you are over pompous, when you are so proud of yourself, God can reduce us to something. God taught this man the lesson of his life. You don't joke with, you don't mess up with children of the light. You don't mess up with God's creatures. We are the apple of God's eye. God fights the battle for us. So, Zacchaeus tonight did not allow his natural barrier to weigh him down. He was able to fight. So he ran ahead. He ran ahead and climbed the sycamore tree to see if he could catch a glimpse of Jesus. I'm telling you tonight that the effort we make will be rewarded in Jesus' name. Every effort you make to come to this prayer line will be rewarded in Jesus' name. I'm talking to each and every one of us. You think that God does not know that you are always on this line from Monday to Monday? You must be joking. Remember that Jesus said that time will come and the hour has come when people will not worship on the mountain nor in the synagogue. God knew that this day will come. Jesus prophesied for our own generation when we are worshiping and praying and adoring and glorifying God on the line. You see how God works. You can imagine how many years Jesus came into this world and the things that are happening now. I'm telling you that every effort you make will be rewarded. Every effort you make to help to take care of your siblings, God knows that you're suffering a lot. You don't sleep. You have two jobs. You maintain your family here. You maintain your children. You maintain the people in Nigeria and all walks of life. You are alone. You are the breadwinner. And you think that God does not notice that? And you are looking for people to thank you and compensate you? And when you make calls home, all you get is just anger. God hears everything. God knows everything. I'm talking to you. God loves you. Every effort you make to help your siblings, your husband, your wife, your children will be rewarded. Tonight, I'm talking to you. Tonight is your night. Look at Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus did not allow his natural impediment to disrupt his plan. He did not allow his natural impediment to bench him at home. He heard about Jesus. He didn't shy away from the crowd because he was very short. He was a short man. No. Who cares? His eyes was focused on Jesus. I want you to learn something from Zacchaeus tonight. No matter what your impediment is, be it natural or by accident, do not allow it to cripple you or to bench you at home. Be proud. Look at the mirror and say that I am the apple of God's eyes. Jesus is interested in me. Jesus is interested in me. I told you a story one time ago. I went to the handicap, the special need children in Nigeria when I went to Nigeria to give them little thing I have. One of the little child asked me, Father, why am I like this? She was crippled. I said, my child, I can't answer this. It's only God that can answer this. Because the sister, the nun that was taking care of them, she told me that this child never laughed. She was always wearing gloomy face. She wasn't happy. Can I see that child? If I didn't have chance, can I see that child at least for me to cheer her up? I said, okay, let's see what Jesus can do for this child. I went to her and said, hi. She was just looking at me like the sister described her. I said, how are you today? She was looking at me. And I said, is there anything you want to ask Jesus? He said, yes. He asked me, why am I like this? Why am I like other people, other children are jumping up, they're playing, but why am I on the ground? I don't know. Why? Why will I be happy? If you look at me, I was freezing. I didn't know the answer. I couldn't defend Jesus. I couldn't defend God there. All I told her was, it's the creator of you and me who answer this. Even though I'm the messenger, I don't have the answer. But I've come to comfort you. I've come with my presence to share with you, to show you that even if Jesus did not come down, that somebody can. And he asked me another question. Will I be like this in heaven? Very intelligent child. And that gave me a room. There was an insight. I said, well, let me tell you. We don't need this body to go to heaven. Whether you are standing or sitting or lying down, whether you are crippled or handicapped or okay, when we die, this body will perish. This body is for the insect. This body is for the mort. Dust unto dust. That our precious soul will go to heaven. She was looking at me, and she became brighter and brighter, and she smiled. I told her, in heaven, there is no cripple, there is no handicap. In heaven, everything is complete. And she hugged me and smiled and laughed. And I sang a song for her. The song is, I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves you and me. Oh, she smiled and laughed loudly. Sister was surprised. She came out from her office and said, Anthony, what did you do to this girl that she was able to laugh for the first time? I said, I did not do anything extraordinary. It was divine intervention. It was God that packaged tonight and that very day, that was the day the child will be relieved and liberated from that captivity that she was in. Why must she be in that impediment and at the same time not happy? And she has been going through this for many days. And I broke the silence of that impediment. Since that day on, sister was telling me she sang that song almost every day and she was engaged with other kids and sons. I did not do anything. I'm an unworthy servant. But I'm just trying to tell you something, that sometimes we are into ourselves that we forget that God is interested in us. Zacchaeus did not allow his natural impediment to disrupt his attention and focus upon Jesus. He did not shy away from the crowd. He knew who he was. He knew how he was unworthy. How unworthy he was, how he was perceived by the people, how people see him. He humbly decided to go extra mile to climb the tree. Imagine a rich man climbing a mango tree to pluck a fruit. You can imagine. A rich man, wealthy man, like Zacchaeus. Imagine him climbing up. Sometimes we look around and we say, oh, this rich man, why are they in the church? Some rich men are very humble. Not all of them are bad. In spite of their richness, they are very humble. So we're told today that Zacchaeus was very rich and still wanted to see Jesus. It wasn't the faith of Zacchaeus, it was the effort of Zacchaeus. He did not even allow his impediment to weigh him down. Let me tell you, your effort will not go unnoticed. The effort of Zacchaeus did not go unnoticed by the master, who was able to foresee the direction Jesus was going that day. Watch the drama in verse 5. Gospel of Luke, remember? Gospel of Luke chapter 19 from verse 1 to 10. And look at verse 5. Watch the drama unfolding. Jesus reached the spot where the tree was and stopped. Not only that Jesus stopped, Jesus looked up and spoke to Zacchaeus, saying, Zacchaeus, come down. Who told Jesus the name of that man? Who told Jesus that he was on the tree? Look at that. The crowd was following Jesus. Jesus was preaching to the crowd. And still was able to know that somebody was on the sycamore tree. You cannot hide from the Lord. Your family is not hidden from the Lord. Your problem is not hidden from the Lord. Your condition is not hidden from the Lord. Your job problem is solved tonight. What you are going through, God knows. Your barrenness, God knows. Let me tell you, I'm talking to you. What you are going through in that your family, God knows about it. You, I'm talking to you. Jesus will come to your house and stop. Jesus will come to you. Jesus will never pass your own street without visiting your house tonight. Jesus stopped and looked up. Jesus had time for you. That's why he's interested in you. That is the caption of tonight's blessing and reflection. Jesus stopped and looked up. And not only that he looked up, he was able to see Zacchaeus. In spite of the crowd, he left the crowd and was focused. His attention was focused on Zacchaeus. Let me tell you, when the heaven wants to bless you, everything stops and you are in charge at that very moment, at that defined moment. I'm talking to you. Your own turn is coming for that blessing. You have to claim that blessing tonight. Because tonight is your own night. I'm talking to you. Jesus was able to look up and spoke to Zacchaeus. Look at what Jesus told Zacchaeus. Come down. Which means Jesus was able to wait for him to come down. Jesus was patient enough in spite of the crowd, in spite of his tight schedule, in spite of his ministration. He was able to stand and wait for Zacchaeus. Go and write it in your diary that Jesus is patient with you because he is interested in you. Jesus has time for you. Even when your friends do not have time for you, somebody has time for you. Somebody has time for you. Hallelujah, somebody. For Jesus is talking to you tonight. He told Zacchaeus to come down. I don't know who told Jesus the name of Zacchaeus. I don't know who told Jesus that he was on the tree. All-knowing God knows your problem. All-knowing God knows your unworthiness. All-knowing God knows how people perceive you. All-knowing God knows what people gossip about you. In spite of all this, Jesus stopped by and waited for Zacchaeus. Therefore, tonight is your night. Jesus will stop by you. Jesus will stop by you and wait for you to come and receive your breakthrough. You will be able to receive your blessing. You will be able to receive your liberation tonight. You will be able to be free from disappointment. Your disappointment is over. Your disappointment is over. Your barrenness is over. Your childlessness is over. Your child, your miraculous child is on the way. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. You are looking for a mate child. God will give you twins. Woo! Claim tonight. You are looking for a child and God has given you, has planned triplet for you. You don't even know what God has in package for you. You are looking for the fruit of the womb, and God has given you a bouncing baby girl that will tell you, oh, mom, I will help you in the kitchen. I will help you in the kitchen. Mom, I'm with you. You don't even know why God gives you your special children. And you are crying. Every child matters for God, whether you have a daughter or you have a son. A child is a child. But God will give you your own heart desire in Jesus' name. If you want to have a boy, God will give you twin boys and men. If you want to have a girl, God will give you a double. All you have to be is to focus your attention on the Lord. Zacchaeus was not distracted by his natural impediment. He was all focused on the Lord. I'm talking to you tonight. because your job opportunity is confirmed. Your miscarriage is gone, for Jesus is passing your own country and is coming to dwell with you. Your hour of deliverance is near. That's your troubled children. God is delivering them tonight. I'm talking to your family. Jesus is waiting for you to receive your freedom. That imprisoned brother of yours, I'm talking to you. God will set him free. The hour has come when the Lord will liberate you from their captivity. That your brother that was imprisoned will come out very soon. Your imprisoned sister that is living in bondage, God will liberate her from that captivity. Your family that has been in bondage will be free and liberated tonight. I'm talking to you. Let me tell you, tonight is your night. I'm talking to you. Let me tell you, tonight is your night. Your sickness is gone, I'm telling you, my brother and your sister. Zacchaeus came down immediately, as we can see in verse 5, because who he was going up to the tree to see came at the spot where he was looking for Jesus. He was looking for Jesus, and the reverse was the case. Jesus was looking for him. When you are looking for Jesus, Jesus is looking for you. The measure with which you measure will be measured unto you. The Bible cannot deceive us. You have been searching and looking for Jesus, and you have been dining with Jesus on this line, Monday to Monday. You think that Jesus is not looking at you. You think it's by your might that you are sustaining yourself in spite of what you are going through. Your suitor is in Nigeria. You don't have your paper here. And you are still alive, bouncing. You have problems. You have cancer problems. And people were thinking you can die. Nobody sees your sickness except you and God. And you look so, you're so beautiful. And you are smiling. And you are sustained by the grace of God. It's only when you tell people, when you tell people your problem, they will know. You have to ask yourself, how am I surviving? What is the surviving strategy that I have? It is the Holy Ghost. It's the Holy Spirit that is doing that. It's the grace of God that is sustaining you. Smile and laugh and shake your body tonight. Because God will never leave your house. God will never leave your house. God will never leave you. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. And you are carrying the image and likeness of God. Don't forget that. Because God is interested in you. Zacchaeus came down immediately, as we can see in verse 5. And Jesus said, I must stay in your house today. Look at Jesus making that command. I must stay in your house. Which means that all-knowing God knew what people were thinking. Do you know the meaning of that must? It is confirmed. Command. The must is a command. And what I'm hearing is very assertive. And in an affirmative way, Jesus was confirming his visit to Zacchaeus' house, which means there will be no change of plan by the Master Jesus with regard to his visit to Zacchaeus' house. Nothing will stop him from visiting Zacchaeus' house. Oh, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus is talking to somebody tonight. I must stay with you in your condition. I must visit you in your condition. I must visit you, and you will be healed. You will be liberated. You will be liberated from your captivity. You can never be benched by that condition. He will visit your village. He will visit your village and uproot and annihilate any type of presence and power. Oh, that sleepless night you are having. Oh, that bad dreams. Oh, that bad dream must stop because you are temple of the Holy Spirit. God is talking to you tonight. I'm talking to you. I do not care how people rate you, how people talk about you, how you are perceived. Jesus is saying this. That's what I'm hearing tonight. I must stay in your house today. And Jesus is coming to stay in your office. That your office will flourish once again. I'm talking to you tonight. When Jesus stepped his feet into Peter's boat, oh, he was able to catch a lot of fish. That's your agency. That's your office. That's your business. Jesus is stepping his feet inside us. Oh, he can never pass without coming to that office to bless it. He can never pass without coming to that office. God is coming to your business, the business of your children, all the people you are praying for. God will visit them tonight. Tonight is your night. Jesus is interested in you. Jesus is interested in me. That is the reflection of tonight. That is the caption of today's of reflection. Jesus is coming to your office. Tonight, Jesus is visiting you on your sick bed. Jesus is coming there to rebuke that sickness. Jesus is coming to visit your condition. Yes, Jesus is visiting you today. He is coming to visit your condition, your predicament. Your green card is on the way. Your green card is on the way. Somebody will see you through. I'm talking to you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I'm talking to you tonight. Somebody will see you through. You know, angels walk in form of human beings in many ways, in many counties. You never know who you will meet one day, and there will be divine breakthrough for you. Help is on the way. Don't give up. Don't give up. Heaven, help is on the way. Jesus is coming to your house tonight to talk to your husband. I'm talking to you. Yes, you. Jesus is coming to talk to that your husband. Yes. Even though he doesn't come to pray, Jesus will come to him tonight. Jesus is talking to you. Jesus is talking to that your wife. Yes, I'm talking to you. Yes. You have been trying to make things happen. Oh, God is visiting each and every one of us. There will be a call that will have divine breakthrough for you. Jesus is talking to you tonight. Jesus is talking to your children tonight. Those are your children that are ushers and recalcitrant. You think that they cannot listen to you. God will whisper into their ears. And they will be able to obey daddy and mommy. 9 months is not 9 days. Are you kidding me? God will bend them. They will be able to recognize you. They will be able to recognize that you are the mother. You are the father of the house. I'm talking to you tonight. Your children will be, they're born to succeed. The enemies cannot take away your children. Precise and powers cannot bend them over. I'm talking to you tonight. God will win back your siblings for you. Your in-laws will recognize you. Your friends will know that you are there. Your job has been, oh no, your job has been your headache. You are wahala. I'm talking, Jesus will visit that job. All those people that made you to have that restlessness and that indefinite suspension, God is talking to them tonight. The staff of Moses will come and knock at that office and you will be back again in Jesus' name. You will be able to go back to the promised land. I'm talking to you tonight. Jesus has come to show you that he is interested in you. You have to claim divine blessing tonight because Jesus has come to liberate you from that captivity. Your colleagues that plot against you, God will arrest the situation. I'm talking to you. You are coming back. I'm talking to you, my child. Child of God, be happy. God has visited you tonight. Jesus is interested. Look at Zacchaeus. It never occurred to him that Jesus would stop where he was hiding and trying to catch a glimpse of Jesus. It never occurred to him that Jesus would come at that spot and stop and wait for him to come down from the tree. Look at that. Let me tell you, Jesus must visit that case. You are going back to your job. That case in the court, both home and abroad, Jesus is visiting all those cases. Many doors will open for you. Even the one that was closed will open. It is you that will be making choice where you will go. I'm talking to you tonight. Daughter of Zion, you haven't been married before. Or you are married and you still want to marry. God is talking to you. Your husband is on the way. Child of God, you want to get a good wife. I'm talking to God who present a good wife for you. I'm talking to you tonight. You don't even know that God is interested in you. How can you pass on notice? Jesus is visiting your house. People will know that you are there. And for my daughters that are waiting for their husband to come, you will start listening, you will start having suitors. And your phone will be ringing. It is you that will be making the selection. You are the daughter of Zion. You are a child of God. Jesus was able to wait for Zacchaeus to come down. And once he came down, he welcomed Jesus gladly. Who will not welcome Jesus gladly? Jesus waited for him. Look at, people regarded Zacchaeus as an unworthy man, as a worldly man, but that very day, in spite of those things that people had in mind, Jesus celebrated Zacchaeus. Jesus used that same crowd that knew about the life of Zacchaeus to celebrate Zacchaeus' salvation. Jesus used that same crowd. Of course, I know that most of his gossipers will be there too. Most of his enemies may have been there. And you see how Jesus did it in the Bible tonight. He used the same crowd to celebrate Zacchaeus that was very pinchomic and short. I'm talking to you tonight that God will make you a princess among your enemies, a prince among your enemies. A prince among your enemies and witches and wizards will not have power over you. You are a child of God. God is interested in you. Look at verse 7. Look at verse 7 of tonight's reflection. Gospel of Luke chapter 19, verse 7. It says, all the people saw this and began to mutter. They will mumble. They were saying, he has gone to be the guest of a sinner. You see, the judgmental minds. Oh, they had already tagged him a sinner. And then look at Jesus. He was going to be dining with a sinner, which implies he will be unclean. When somebody that is perfect goes to an imperfect place, oh, that perfection goes to imperfection. That was God's ways are not our ways. When perfection goes into an imperfect place, that imperfect way becomes like alum that you put inside unclean water, and that water becomes clean. Hello? I'm talking to somebody tonight. You don't know how God works. I know that many of us from Nigeria, you know what is alum. When you don't have a clean water, some people put alum inside the water. And then the debris will go down and the clean water will surface. In some way, when Jesus comes into your life, that imperfection will go. If you're a divine instrument and you meet a child of God that God wants you to convert, you don't allow that child of God that has been struggling with her life or his life to weigh you down. You are going there for rescue operation. You are the first responder. You are the spiritual first responder. You are trying to help that child of God to stand on his or her own feet. You don't shy away. You don't be afraid. If you are a divine instrument, you don't be afraid because you know that your God is with you. Oh, when God blesses you, your enemies will know. When God blesses you, all those gossipers will know. I would like you to sing this song tonight because you are so precious in the eyes of the Lord. When my breakthrough comes, children of God, we know. When my breakthrough comes, children of God, we know. When my breakthrough comes, children of God, we know. When my breakthrough comes, children of God, we know. My enemies will run away. God will surprise them, you know. For my breakthrough has come. I am happy in the Lord. You see, when your breakthrough comes, that's what happened tonight. When you are reading Zacchaeus tonight, you'll be able to be in the shoe of Zacchaeus. People were murmuring. They were murmuring, and they were muttering a lot of things which we may not even see and know. And but God was able to observe all this. They were saying, he has gone to be the guest of a sinner. That was the actual thing that was written on the Bible. The Bible presents the situation in the crowd. My dear child, you don't need to be frustrated. Zacchaeus up in verse 8 because Jesus has stepped into his situation. And in front of the crowd that has been following him, he was able to say to Jesus, I will divide half of my wealth and give to the poor, because he knew that Jesus loved the poor. And at the same time, he knew that his past life was not good in the eyes of people. And Jesus gave him second chance and gave him the opportunity to amend his way. Everybody deserves second chance. Think about it. I don't want to stretch it, but look at it. And knowing what you know now, there are certain things you wouldn't have done or allowed to happen in your life. Look at Zacchaeus. And look at what people were saying about Zacchaeus. And look at Zacchaeus himself. In spite of his natural impediment, he was trying to make effort. Our effort is in God. God sees our effort. He's not a fault finder. God sees each and everyone's effort. God is not a fault finder. Look at Zacchaeus tonight. And so what Jesus did in his life in front of the crowd that knew who he was. Jesus did not shy away from going to the sinner. He didn't care what people would say about he himself going to the rich man or going to the sinner. He knew his mission and vision. It's only when you lose sight of your vision that you falter and you start listening to all these cock and bull stories and the brouhaha of the people. You have to remain focused. If you are with the Lord and you are working for the Lord, you don't need to listen to the world, because you're in the world. Even though you are in the world, but you're not of the world. You don't belong there. You are in the cult of Jesus. You are in the cult of Jesus. Even though you are in the world, you are not of the world or for the world. You are for Jesus. You are for the Jesus, the Emmanuel, God with us. So Zacchaeus stood up in front of the crowd and confessed his sins and amended his way. Will you be able to humble yourself and say, I am the cause of the problem in my family? If you are the cause, will you be able to stomach your pride and say, I'm so sorry? If I am wrong, then I am sorry. So sorry, Lord. Deep in my eyes, I know it's true. I have offended my Lord. I know it, Lord. I have offended the Lord. I know it, Lord. I am sorry, Lord. I am sorry, Lord. I am coming back to you. If I am wrong to my sister, I am sorry. If I am wrong to my brother, I am sorry. If I am wrong, I'm sorry. I am so sorry, Lord. Why wouldn't God accept you? Because you have stomached your pride and said, I'm so sorry. And God is listening to you tonight. Knowing what you know now, there are certain things you wouldn't have done. Sometimes we listen to our emotions and we go too far. We have to listen to the Spirit of God and listen to the epikaya, the Spirit of the law, not the letters of the law. We have to look at God and look at tonight's activity and the story and be able to know that God is talking to us. Zacchaeus amended his ways. This is an opportunity for us to amend our ways, our lifestyle, the way we talk, the way we behave that is ungodly. We have to amend our ways and then bond with God and our neighbor and friends, and God will talk to us like he spoke to Zacchaeus. He said in verse 9, salvation has come to this house. Do you know that salvation can come to your house? Let us pray tonight. Loving Father, I thank you for allowing us to listen to your word in the scripture. Your word is cement. I am nothing. But you have used me as a divine instrument to talk to my brothers and sisters. Oh, Lord, I pray that you write down your divine blessing and grace upon my brothers and sisters on this line, for them to receive your divine grace and breakthrough. You are able to visit Zacchaeus' house in spite of his unworthiness. I pray that you be able to visit our houses one by one. We cannot do all the job, but my Lord, you have the power. You are beyond the superpower. You are supersonic, and you are beyond the supersonic world. I pray that you rain down your divine grace upon us one by one to visit us, O Lord. Help us to be able to conquer our natural impediments, to be able to move on. In spite of what people say about us, do not allow the world to define us, O Lord. I pray that you render your divine blessing upon us, children. Many are going through a lot, but they are waiting upon your miracle and blessing. I know that tonight is for them. Grant them divine mercy. Grant them divine mercy. Grant them divine mercy. Grant them divine favor. Let there be open doors. Let there be liberation for those that are in captivity. Oh God, I pray that you minister to those people that are looking and yearning for you. Don't let the barren see and hear the voice of children in their house. Oh, the people that are looking for male children, oh God, I pray for male children to come upon them. Female children to come upon the barren, and male children to come upon the barren, that they will be free from the barrenness, O God. I pray for students, for my siblings, my brothers, and sisters, for all that are looking for their fruit of the womb, and for all that are looking for their life partners. I pray you bless them tonight. Tonight is the night. I pray for deliverance for many people that are going through a lot. Many children have been living in bondage, and the family don't know what to do. It is you that will grant that divine liberation. I pray for your divine breakthrough upon their families. As salvation has been granted to our brother Zacchaeus, let salvation come unto us today. The sinners are waiting upon the Lord for you to forgive and forgive and forgive and forgive. Do not remember our past, O Lord. Brother, Lord, may you bless the future and the present. They are yearning and craving for you, O Lord. Let tonight bring them solace. They have cried a lot. May you bless our effort. Bless the effort of my brothers and sisters tonight. May you bless their effort and grant them divine favor. As you waited for Zacchaeus to come down from the tree, we are waiting unto you, Father, to bless each and every one of us tonight. I believe that today, since you are interested in us, that we have received your divine favor. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen.